my new office. And if the camera wasn't mounted to something that doesn't move, I would show you around a little bit. But you're seeing a little glimpse into the window of the space I lovingly call the Sound Healing Center of Lexington. I opened the space about a month ago, or this month, which is, it's almost been a month, since the first sound bath in the new studio space. And this is the first full moon that I've had in this space. So, very happy to welcome you in if you haven't already been here before. If you haven't been here and you are close to me in Lexington, Kentucky, or wish to make a trip to Lexington to see it in person, I would love to have you teaching lots of workshops coming up and having weekly sound baths every Sunday night. Obviously, we're going to continue doing our full moon sound healing virtually as well for those of you that can't make it. But yeah, I'm real excited. I have had a kind of crappy week. I know we just came off the Thanksgiving holiday, and there are lots of things to be thankful for. I just didn't think that I would be spending the bulk of Thanksgiving break in the hospital. So my oldest daughter was admitted last Monday night, so a week ago, and with diabetic ketoacidosis. What that means is that we discovered and learned for the first time that she is a type 1 diabetic. So that has put us through the ringer last week. Like I said, there's a lot to be thankful for, and it's just weird adapting to something like that new. So the question that came up for me in last night's sound bath as I was working with the smaller group is what do I need to feel safe to surrender? And it came up, the question sort of rolled around in my mind until it came, and, you know, first I wanted to start with a how do I surrender, but I realized that wasn't the right question, and then, so I asked the what question, and that's where I ended up. What do I need to feel safe to surrender? And I'm still looking into that question, and I feel like it's a lot more universal than just me. So I wanted to bring that and share that with you about where I am and why I'm kind of there. I have had three words that have come out since that question entered into my awareness. The first word that came about was practice. The second one that came up was trust. And the third was faith. So the more I dive into this, the more there is to explore this concept of surrender, which is a routine concept that continues to kind of circulate around me and come into my awareness every so often. So this is even deeper surrender and learning to do that. So that's what I'm going to be working on today, and sort of leaning into what that looks like. Yeah, so I feel like even though I've been in the space for a month, because this is my first full moon sound healing in my new office space, I feel unprepared. I have my bowls, but I feel like I'm missing something. At the same time, I feel like I have everything I need. You know, I usually bring a thing. I usually have a crystal. I usually have an oil. I usually have my rattle. I have things, right? And this transition from the other space to this space has coincided with this transition within my family. And perhaps you've experienced the transition as well, because I do feel like we are moving out of another timeline into a new one. There is a transitioning happening somewhere in your life, and there is a need to surrender to it. So maybe we're surrendering to life. Maybe we're surrendering to the flow. Maybe we're surrendering to our higher selves and whatever plan or theme we've chosen for ourselves before entering into this incarnation. And I'm still figuring all of that out right alongside of you. As I move forward in my healing journey, I share that with you and hope that it resonates and helps in some way. So today I'm playing the bowls with the hope for some clarity. That's my intention around this surrendering topic. How I'm meant to serve through this transition in my life, from being a practitioner to holding space in a center and inviting these new energies in, that feels expansive and scary. So think about what transition you're going through right now. Think about where you have been and what you are moving through, because it feels expansive and scary. And as always, I invite you to set an intention for today's practice, to allow yourselves to explore deeper, maybe some recurring themes, such as surrender, if that is a theme for you. If that is not a theme for you, just take a moment. And if you even need to pause this and come back to it, pause to find even just one word for your focus for today. Okay? So once you have your theme, your intention for today's practice, please get into a comfortable position, lying down or sitting, or doing some sort of mindless chore if that feels good to you, washing the dishes, cleaning the house. Just not anything where you really need to be consciously and alertly aware. No driving, please. Don't do this when you're trying to engage with other people and other varieties of that. So if you are able to, close your eyes. We're going to start, as always, with some breaths. Breathing in, expanding your lungs. Fully exhaling. And with these breaths in, bringing awareness into the body. Feeling your body expand, rise and fall. Consciously disconnecting from whatever energies you were previously engaged with. So if you were online or talking to someone, draw your energy back into yourself with the inhale. Disconnect from the outside with the exhale. Settling down deeper in your root. Calling the energy back with the inhale. And with the exhale, relaxing deeper. Your legs feel heavier. Your body feels more rooted into the ground. You feel more stable. Today, the intention is for a clearing so that we can clear out some of the old patterns and just habits and routines that we are shifting away from. So as I play the root chakra bowl, any beliefs that are in our root that aren't serving us or previously served us but aren't going to serve us moving forward, they're being cleared away. With each exhale, you feel safer in your body. Wiggling your fingers and toes. Stretching if that feels good. Finding yourself in seated position if that feels good. And whenever you're ready, open your eyes. So, for me, the energy of a lot of this is actually sadness and grief. And for whatever we're leaving behind, right? What we are surrendering and letting go of, we're gonna feel sadness and grief for the way it once was. And that doesn't mean there's not beauty in the future, but where I can grieve what once was. And I spent a lot of time really clearing out each and every energy center on the way up, and also connecting them and making it so that as they are cleared, they are more connected. And at least for me, what felt most potent was in the heart and the throat and the third eye this time. So I feel that we're going to be grieving. That's in our heart center. And I feel like, you know, as I said, what we've left behind, but there's also the feelings of voicing our concerns about the future, and then working on the intuition piece, because I know at least myself, there's a degree of not trusting the intuition, self-doubt. There was work in the solar plexus around that as well. But it's being cleared out. So flush your system with some clean water today. If you can get outside and get grounded, that would be great. Take a salt bath if that is available to you. I, as always, encourage your feedback. I would love to know what you think about the sound in the new space. And I look forward to seeing you next month. I love you. Bye.